Probably. We're speeding, South Speed.
Here we go. Hooah!
Hooah! That'd be a weird
The thing. Real Housewives of the Umbrella Academy. Reunion. Here we go.
This isn't your home.
What are you talking about? This is the Umbrella Academy.
This is the Sparrow Academy.
Hello, hello, Geeked Week! I am Felicia Day, and I am so excited to be here for this very special Geeked Week panel for the Umbrella Academy. Yes, finally all those purple umbrellas in the chat have paid off. We are going to treat you to some exclusive first looks at Season 3 in just a little bit, but want to know what's even more of a treat? I have gathered up as many of the fabulous cast behind the Umbrella Academy as I could to share those first looks with you. So, without further ado, let's welcome our panel. Tom Hopper, who plays the number one in our hearts and for the Umbrella Academy, Luther. David Castañeda, who plays Master of Knives and the Brellies number two, Diego. Emmy Raver-Lampman, who I heard a rumor plays the fabulous number three, Allison. Aidan Gallagher, who plays the well overdue for not having apocalypse crises to deal with, number five. Hey. Justin H. Min, who plays Ben, now number two of the Sparrow Academy. We're going to have to talk about that. Mm-hmm. And Genesis Rodriguez as the newest member of our cast, the number five of the Sparrow Academy, Sloan. Thank you, everybody, for being here. Thank you also to everyone who responded to at the Umbrella Academy and at Netflix Geeks with your fan questions for this panel. We got so many of them. We will do our best to answer as many as we can throughout the show. So, Season 2 ended up with quite a cliffhanger. Can you guys talk about where things pick up for Season 3 for each of your characters? Tom, do you want to start?
Well, I guess we start with seeing the Sparrow Academy, right? And then dealing with the fact that this is not our timeline anymore, right? So I think for Luther, I think the pressure's off for him now, initially, right? I think until any problems start occurring, he thinks, well, great, well, we can just kind of get on with our lives here then, because we don't have any pressure, we can just crack on. So, yeah, that's certainly where it starts for Luther, and until, as I say, problems start happening.
Yeah, pretty much immediately, right?
Yeah.
Emmy, where is Allison in this moment when you start up Season 3?
I think everyone's a little jumbled by the fact that we've come home to find out that our home is not our home, and there's strangers on the balcony.
David seems pretty. Your character seems pretty aggro when you see everybody. Yeah, ready to start fighting?
Yeah. So sort of an identity crisis.
Yeah.
You know.
But I think Allison's priority, the reason that she agreed to go with the rest of the family and leave the 60s, was to get home to her daughter. So that's her first priority and her only priority, to be honest.
Yeah, as any mother would.
Yeah.
Any good mother.
Yeah.
I guess.
Absolutely.
To judge anybody's mother. Sorry, Mom. Aidan, how is Fi feeling when you see this? I mean, you probably have seen enough disaster to, you know, fill the whole garbage can. What are you thinking right now when you see this other team?
I think he's flustered. I mean, he's seen his fair share of crazy timeline and whatnot. So he keeps an eye on the briefcase, but it's in the back of his mind whether or not to use that, because who knows, this might be fine.
Yeah.
It might just be that we're out of a home, in which case, just, I don't know,
find
a realtor or something.
Exactly.
Yeah. Realtor.
Yeah.
Zillow.
Or a ball of coin.
Now, Justin, you are on the other side of the world. You're facing off against your old Brellies. How does that feel?
Traitor.
Oh. Wow.
She went there.
Starting this interview off spicy. We are set up where we're having a typical day at the Sparrow Academy, our beautiful home, and then suddenly out of nowhere, these strangers appear and they're looking at Ben in this odd way. So I think he's startled and also suspicious of who these people are and why they're here.
Yeah. Alternate universe, alternate academy. Let's talk about the Sparrows. Genesis, what do we need to know about the Sparrow Academy in general?
The Sparrow Academy is a completely different family, equally as dysfunctional, but they really are crime fighters. They're organized, they have trained their entire lives, and they've dedicated their lives to stopping crime. And they're kind of a big deal. They're very popular.
Very Ron Burgundy.
They're very popular. And
lots of billboards.
Lots of billboards. They're a brand.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, they're a brand. So they've succeeded where the Brellies maybe haven't, as far as marketing.
Wow.
Maybe
wow.
The billboard should say we're kind of a big deal.
We're kind of a big deal.
Kind of a big deal.
Trademark. Well, we have our first sneak peek for Geek Week. We brought everyone an exclusive clip, so I hope you're excited about that. Let's take a look.
Big one is strong, but slow, possibly stupid. Some sort of simian hybrid.
Who took the little jumpy guy?
Me. Just gave him a spanking and sent him to school.
Hello.
The skinny one is their weak link.
Less hiding behind couches shouting, where's my daddy?
It's a superpower. They disrespected us, Marcus. We need to be out there finding these freaks and taking them out.
Oh, you mean like this?
I mean, we haven't faced decent enemies for years. This could be good for us. Good for business. But only if we're smart with our next move.
Okay, can we? Can we not?
You clearly had a trainer too. You're ripped. I'm sorry to bring it up.
Hey, can we not?
We love this for you.
Yes, they had all of us on quite intense training regimens before we started the show, and so it was sort of nice to get into the character in a physical way, in a way that I haven't been able to do previously for the show. So. Mm-hmm.
Well, I'm sure the fans will appreciate it, your dedication.
David will, and that's all that matters.
Yeah, I always do.
Kirby on Twitter asks for Justin, what was it like to work with a new group of people with new powers?
Yeah, Justin, what was that like?
It was wonderful. I mean, I think we had chemistry right away. Mm-hmm. It almost felt like working on a new show. I was playing a sort of a new character with a new cast, and we got to Zoom a number of times before starting filming, and I just felt like it really worked immediately, and it's so lovely. It's so lovely. Of course, you know, love these guys as well, but.
Did you miss it? At all?
Yes.
Emmy's face seems a little skeptical. She's not like where this is going.
The thing is, we so rarely got to actually do scenes with him.
Yeah,
you know?
It's mostly
so
just jealousy.
He was just around.
They actually got to look him in the eyes.
Yeah.
We weren't allowed to for 2 seasons because he was dead.
Yeah. Okay, so flip side.
Absolutely.
Can anybody tell me what's up with the Cube? Christopher the Cube? Is he like a good roommate? What do you think?
He's very opinionated, I do have to say.
Mm-hmm. Follow up to all of you, actually. Who would win in a fight, you or your number opposite? So like Tom, Luther versus Marcus, who would win?
Tight.
Really?
Very tight.
It'd be very tight.
I'm just for my own ego. Tight.
Tight.
Okay.
But he's probably a touch faster than sluggish Luther. So maybe,
All right. What about Diego versus Ben?
I think Ben would win, you know? But Ben would cry. He'd win, but he'd cry.
I was going to say you would cry.
No, but you would win, though.
I would win, so, and you would cry.
Because, hold on, he's emotional in victory.
Because the knife will cut your tentacles, dude, and it would hurt you.
Okay.
And make you cry.
Yeah, that would suck.
I could see that, but I think Ben would kill Diego before the knives could even come out.
I wouldn't die.
Wow.
It's like a tennis match over here. I'm like,
wouldn't die.
Why wouldn't you die?
Because Diego's lovable, dude. You can't kill Diego.
Okay.
So you're saying that Ben's not so lovable?
No, he's terrible.
Oh.
He's terrible. He's a dickhead.
Are we talking real life or fiction right
now? No, Ben. Of course. No, Justin's a little marshmallow. He's like,
That's a compliment. Emmy, Allison versus Faye. Who would win?
Oh, man. I think Allison.
Absolutely.
Oh, okay. What? Yeah.
She's the most powerful of them all.
Yeah. You just have to say three words.
Yeah. I was thinking from the physical aspect, just like actual hand-to-hand combat.
Mm. Oh, punching?
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, you know.
But also, yeah, I do think
if you're actually using
Allison's
your
power is crazy.
Yeah.
That's really incredible. Mm-hmm. So, I'd probably say Allison.
Okay, you take her out. Aidan versus Genesis, you can do it right now.
This is a tricky one.
No, it's not what you think. It's a game of checkers. I think Five would diffuse the conflict rather than fight. Like
talk it out.
Well, he'd
talk it out.
See
or
if
just...
you guys are actually a threat or just like you're in our house. Mm-hmm. We weren't expecting guests. We need to prepare before.
Over a drink.
Yeah.
So you would negotiate your way out of any conflict.
I think Five would make sure he understood the scenario before he starts killing people.
Okay.
Oh, wow.
You've never done that before. You just kill people. Am I just seeing the same show?
I check, like, the guest list who's in the boardroom before I head in with the axe.
Okay. Before the massacre.
Yeah.
No, just forget the whole Assassin's Guild thing. I'll make sure everyone's present.
But if I wasn't quick, she would totally win.
Yeah.
He's just got that blink thing, so he's got to be quick.
Yeah. Okay. Gravity gal.
Gravity.
The Brellies evolve so much each season, and the Sparrows certainly are a new challenge. What different sides of your characters are you most excited to explore in season 3? Tom, let's start with you.
I think Luther lets go of a lot of his hang-ups. So he's more fun to play this year. I feel like this year he gets to play out his missed teenage years a little bit. Mm-hmm. I'll say that, yeah.
I'm sorry, whenever I look at you, you look so skinny.
Yeah.
I mean, it's almost startling, like, you know, like one of those 80s videos where they just squish people.
Yeah.
It's really good. Yeah. This guy could use a leg day, that's all I could say. David, what about you? David, what about you, your character in season 3?
I think they're bigger than mine. Even more.
I'm sorry.
I don't know, I think it's more about, you know, he's always wanting to save, well, prove himself. And now he's not at home anymore, and there's another academy, so he's a bit lost. He doesn't know what to do, so he wants to just focus his whole attention into, like, trying to get the Sparrow Academy out. Mm-hmm. It, obviously, you know, surprises happen that lead him in a different direction that, you know, kind of helps him find purpose, you know? So he's kind of purposeless at the beginning. He doesn't know what to do with himself, and that's kind of the journey that he goes into, I think, until... you know, the end of season 3.
Yeah. Emmy, where does Allison go? I mean, you've been a lot of places the first couple seasons. Yes. Where are you going from here?
I think Allison's got some trauma that she needs to kind of deal with and move through and work through. And so I think that's a lot of her season is kind of coming back from the 60s and dealing with what she experienced and witnessed and lived through and survived, to be completely honest. Mm-hmm. And that affects her emotionally, mentally, physically. So I think that's a lot of her season is kind of dealing with the aftermath of coming back from being a Black woman in the 60s in Dallas, Texas.
Yeah, which is a lot of trauma.
Yeah, a lot.
Aidan, where's 5 going from here? I mean, you've had to manage so much time travel. What are you just hoping for in this season?
He goes straight to the horse races and kicks back. he's looking for a break, you know. He's been going at it nonstop for, like, 2 weeks now, so.
It's so true. Yeah,
it's tough 2 weeks.
A total of 20 days. 2 weeks. Wow. When you summarize the show like that, it's a little scary. Captain Christine asked for Justin, how did you choose what traits to bring for this version of Ben? Is this Ben a different Ben than we've seen before?
Absolutely. I think a lot of what Steve Blackman, our showrunner, and I talked about was sort of playing around with this whole idea of nature versus nurture and how much of sort of the essence of Ben we wanted to keep and how much he would change because of this sort of different environment that he grew up in. And I think Ben, as his essence, is a very impressionable person. So the nurture part of it plays a much, much larger role in his life than for potentially other characters. So to grow up in an environment that felt more militant and, you know, training to be a crime fighter in all of these ways, it really toughened him up in a way that he wasn't in the previous timeline. He's sort of has a large chip on his shoulder, so that's something that we wanted to bring into play as well.
Yeah, your dad doesn't feel very nurturing this season.
Absolutely.
Is he ever?
Yeah.
Genesis, how do the Sparrows serve as foils for the Brellies? I mean, they're matched power-wise, but are they matched personality-wise, too? Do you have anything in common with 5?
Personality-wise, I wouldn't say we're two different 5s, I believe. But I think that there are some matches within both of the families, for sure. Mm-hmm. Right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Do you think Luther has anything in common with Marcus? And
I think Marcus is the leader that Luther always wanted to be.
Mm. Wow, deep. Ooh,
deep.
Deep.
Yeah.
Deep.
Allison, anything with Faye? Do you have any matchup there?
Their love of birds.
Yeah, why not?
That great, I was like, bird watching. I was like,
yeah, Allison had a pet parakeet. Just didn't make the cut. They're both sassy as hell.
Yeah, I think they're both very, very strong, very, very opinionated and sassy. But I also think that they do have this ability to like to put their family first, mm-hmm. and kind of do what needs to be done for the greater good of the family.
Yeah.
I think both threes are kind of good at being kind of like the pillar of that.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. Kind of the center. Yeah. And then Diego and Ben, you guys are just resentful. you seem to have that in common, resentment.
I think you're everything that
uh-oh.
Ben wants. You're everything that
uh-oh.
Well, exactly what Tom said about Luther, right? Ben is everything Diego wants to be.
I feel like they're both in the same place.
They are.
I think so.
They both have a chip on their shoulder. They both have the number two chip.
Yeah.
I think the difference is that like Diego is not afraid of making a fool out of himself. You know, he really will go there. You know, so he's. But yeah, I think very much both have a imposter syndrome.
And wanting to prove themselves.
Yeah.
Fifth Umbrella on Twitter asks, if your character could have any of the Sparrow's powers or the Sparrow's vice versa, which would they pick? Emmy, you want to start?
My answer has always been the same for three seasons of the show. I think I would keep Allison's power.
It's pretty powerful.
Yeah.
Aidan?
I've been saying for years that gravity manipulation would be a really cool power to have. Mm-hmm. And then it appeared on the show, and I was really happy to see that.
Yeah. Very cool. Justin?
I've grown attached to the tentacles, so...
Literally?
I would keep mine. My Octopus Teacher is also a great documentary on Netflix.
Yes. Yes.
Also on Netflix. Love. Yeah. Love a plug.
Check it out on Netflix. Super depressing, but inspiring. David, what about you?
Wait, what's Marcus's power?
He's the same as Luther.
Yeah,
super
strength.
Super strength.
Just agility. Exactly
smolder is.
Yeah, we're literally the same.
Yeah.
Okay, so it's kind of identical then. Yeah.
Yeah, it's kind of the same. Although Luther has no real obvious power in the show.
Just strong.
I would argue.
He can eat a lot.
Yeah,
I lifted up a tractor in season two.
Yeah.
He wrote the Wikipedia on that.
And still then, with a slight struggle.
But you're still strong. I mean, you lifted me up in season one.
I lifted you up.
Remember?
Yeah.
When we came in.
When was
like,
that?
I'm not like crazy strong.
Yeah. Which I thought was funny because the knives even punctured your arm. Remember that?
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What was the question?
I plead the fifth.
That's
on that
abundantly
one.
Clear. You don't know the question.
Would you keep your powers or would you trade it for another?
Yeah, I'll keep mine.
Okay, you keep yours? Genesis?
I really like my power a lot. I really love Lila's power because she gets all the powers. Mm-hmm. So I'm going to go with Lila.
That feels like a cheat.
Yeah,
I never say that because like a cheat.
She also gets none of them if we're not in the area.
Yeah. Well played.
But then doesn't need them.
Right.
Until she's in our area.
True, right?
Huh?
Until she's amongst us, she doesn't need the power. Right, so when she's off on her own, she's like, I don't need it right now.
She doesn't
but
want that.
When she's fighting us, that's when she needs it, and she can use any of them.
Mm. Okay, it's like wishing for more wishes, but okay. Mm. And you already answered. Would you want to be more like Marcus? Just like maybe more, you can flip at least.
No. No.
I'm sorry.
I've experienced two seasons of like a mediocre version of Marcus.
Okay.
So like just upgrading to Marcus, it's always like, it doesn't serve me.
It's boring.
I think Kazi's power is quite good. Being able to, that's quite fun as well.
Wait, has that been revealed?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we'll just do it.
Okay.
Here's a question. Can Jamie see the other person's dream?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So then
so she can experience
great.
It. She
then
can be whatever she wants it to be.
The look she gave you.
That's fun.
Which is cool.
Okay.
Yeah. So it's a fun power.
Well, we couldn't let a season of The Umbrella Academy go without, you guessed it, Twitter emojis. You will get a special surprise depending on whether or not you're using light or dark mode. So go, take a look. With the Sparrows, we also get a fan favorite setting introduced in season three, Hotel Obsidian. In season one, we had the Umbrella Mansion. In season two, we were in the 60s. What does this new setting of Hotel Obsidian add to the story? David?
Well, I mean, the production of it is just insane. When we got to walk in the first time, it was like you were transported into a different world. Mm-hmm. It was beautiful how they were able to put it. And we shot throughout that whole thing. So it pretty much became the backbone to the whole story.
Yeah. Genesis, did the Sparrow spend a lot of time at this hotel, or is this something you knew you find out in the season?
Yes, there's quite a bit. Mm-hmm. Quite a bit, yeah. In that new space. And really what they were able to do set-wise, it was actually incredible. And with some interesting materials too. Wasn't there like a paper cup holder that was disguised as wall? And
we're very green on the Umbrella Academy. Oh, good. Yeah. We make our sets out of recycling.
Yeah, it was very impressive.
From coffee shops.
Very impressive.
Yeah.
Tom, how many Yelp stars would you give this hotel?
Ooh.
Yeah.
Tricky.
Well, I think it looks a little tired, the Obsidian. It looks like one of those older Vegas hotels.
Okay. Oh, you know, yeah.
Stained carpet, mm-hmm. lots of
not like this.
Smoke stained ceilings.
Yeah,
not like
Tom is used to the Soho. That's why.
Yeah, I guess, I've been spoiled, guys.
Well, that perfectly sets us up for another exclusive clip reveal from season 3 premiere. Let us take a look.
Honestly, okay. I'm gonna work in the back.
There were two entrances, by the way.
Oh, Hotel Obsidian, I missed you, you slutty old dame. Absorb her into your bosom. You know, because back in her heyday, she played host to world leaders. Roosevelt, Gandhi, Stalin, Gorbachev, Castro, King Olaf of Norway, one of the Kim Jongs, Tito, Dalai Lama, Elvis, and not one, but two Kardashians, allegedly. But now, where are you going?
I gotta make a call.
Nowadays, she's just flop house, party house. For those of us not looking to be judged by society's rules and norms,
in a place to hide.
Exactly. It's perfect. And the best part of it is, she's going to look after us. No questions asked. Never.
Right? I may have questions.
Yeah, me too.
This place is weird.
Seems like Klaus, if he recommends a hotel, it's probably not going to be a good experience, huh?
It's tricky, though. In that moment, we needed some place that they couldn't find us. So actually, Klaus was the perfect person to recommend a hotel, because we needed to go to the most unlikely space.
Yeah, but you're right. The production design is pretty astonishing.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, it's incredible.
Yeah, it's insane. Mm-hmm. Well, we have time for a few more questions from fans. D2007_ on Instagram for Tom. Who is your favorite new character of season 3?
Ooh. Actually, I would probably say the new Ben. Ooh. Yeah. Because,
Someone's blushing.
Yeah.
It's pretty great.
It's great. Because it's so different to the Ben that we knew as the Umbrella. So. Mm. I think it's just such a great shift in the show, and it brings a whole new dynamic to your as an actor as well. I think it was brilliant, you know, working with Justin this year. It was so much fun, and so I can't wait for people to see it. It's gonna be good.
Sloane Hargreaves on Twitter asked David, "How many knives do you think Diego owns?"
17.
There it is.
17.
Is that how many you have on you?
Yeah. Is that, and that's all you
okay,
have?
Okay, but what do you have in storage? Like,
that's all I have.
You have no storage
everything
now, right?
Everything got destroyed.
Yeah. Mm. You must be online constantly looking at knives.
I'm very much making sure that I don't lose any of them.
You go to fan conventions? Like,
so there's like a scene right after whatever fight scene where you're just picking up knives?
Yeah, well, it's between the scenes where I'm picking up the knives. You know, it's like the boring stuff. No one wants to see me pick up knives. They want
that
to see me throw them.
That would be a fun blooper reel. Sorry to just go off. I'm just very curious.
That's fine.
Sorry.
No, keep going. I love knives.
Wow.
Especially sharp
she
ones,
loves
right?
coloring.
Will Ferrell
and
Ryan Gosling came out with a knife.
I know what to get you for Christmas.
Exactly. Ina on Twitter for Emmy asks, who do you think is the most powerful amongst the siblings?
Wow.
Oh.
Sparrows and umbrellas?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Both?
You can open it up.
All,
you can
all siblings?
People, yeah.
I mean, I think I would probably say Lila, right? Because she's a chameleon and she can take on any power. So you're always going to be matched by your equal if you go up against her, which is pretty dangerous.
Pretty great.
Yeah.
Chiquetti on Instagram asks, Aidan, do you think you would get along with your character this season?
I'm way too silly for five. He would have none of me.
As we just saw with the knife conversation.
He I would love to see that. I would love to see that conversation.
He'd wait for the coffee to arrive, he'd enjoy it, and then calmly walk out. If I didn't annoy him too much first, and then he would, yeah, I don't know. I don't think he'd like me. He'd be curious. He's like, who's this guy who looks exactly like me? Are we twins who this other one didn't have powers and is just, I don't know.
Captain Caitlin on Twitter for Justin, how does the Umbrella Academy respond to this very different Ben?
Ooh, they're very conflicted because obviously he looks like their Ben, but he acts very differently. And there are many looks shared throughout the show, especially in the first few episodes where they sort of see their Ben, but it's not who they think he is anymore.
Yeah, that must be hard as an actor when you guys have worked for so many years together being one person, for you to remove yourself from them and be a completely different person.
Absolutely, but on the flip side, as was pointed out, it was nice to finally look my fellow actors in the eyes for the first time.
Yeah.
It was
really fun. Likewise, yeah.
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 Yeah. Yeah.
Liam on Twitter for Genesis asks, what is your favorite episode you film for next season?
Ooh.
No spoilers.
I can't really say.
You can get a number.
One and eight.
Ooh. Good numbers.
Before I let you go, we're going to play a little game I like to call Spoilers Without Context. Okay? So the rules are very simple. I want you to share something cryptic. There's a massive spoiler that only will make sense once the fans have seen the whole season. So it could be a sound, it could be a gesture, a facial expression, a word. Anything that gives you a clue in context only if you've seen the season. Tom, I'm sorry.
Oh, I knew you were gonna
say this.
Yeah, I'm sorry.
Yikes.
Whee. I have something.
You have something? Go.
Yeah.
Yes, please.
Lay it on us.
Roll up the carpet. I'll just leave it at that.
I'll say, I'm going to need my bow tie.
Emmy? Bacon.
Bacon?
Yes.
Bacon.
Bacon?
Bacon. Yeah, it's a good one. Aidan? Ah. No, Justin, anything?
Food. So now I'm being inspired by food. Shrimp cocktail and lamb chops.
Ooh. Definitely.
Nice.
Lamb.
Oh. Very smart.
Okay. Hey, lamb. Lamb. Okay.
Lamb.
Okay. Aidan?
I'm just going to say the word breaks. Look at the past stuff that's already come out. Oh. And if you look for the word breaks, you'll find a mild spoiler that won't make sense yet.
Okay, thank you so much. Everybody got it.
If I kill you, do we get our Ben back?
What the hell did you just say?
What are you, their mascot?
More like their ringer. It's a ballroom blitz.
Consider me sufficiently teased. I could keep talking to you all day, but unfortunately that's all the time we have for today's special Geeked Week panel for the Umbrella Academy. Thank you so much for taking the time to chat with us for Geeked Week this year. Fortunately, we don't have to wait much longer until the Umbrella Academy hits Netflix on June 22nd. It's near my birthday, so thank you very much.
Yeah.
You're welcome.
And we will be back with this fabulous crew for a special episode of our Netflix Geeked After Show, The Umbrella Academy Unlocked, where we will go into full spoilery details after the season premieres. All right, see you soon. Thanks. Bye.
Bye.